Day three of this second test match at Lord's, and could England continue their rebuilding job? From 30 for four, Cook and Stokes had dragged them through to 85 for four. And the first hour of this day certainly went England's way. Ben Stokes got through to his 50. Alistair Cook, the captain, wasn't that far behind. One breakthrough for Australia in the morning session. Stokes played on, bowled for 87 by Mitchell Marsh. England fighting hard then, but 181 for five at lunch, still needing another 186 runs to avoid the follow-on. Jos Buttler had a let-off soon after lunch. It appeared he'd been caught behind, but the ball just grounded on replay. Alistair Cook continued to go well, a lovely cover drive, but Buttler was dismissed for 13. That brought Moeen Ali in as the last recognised batsman, and he kept Cook company as England chipped away slowly at Australia's mammoth total. But then the real hammer blow, Cook playing on to Marsh yet again for 96. And at tee, 285 for seven. England still the small matter of 281 runs behind. Well, after tee, Moeen Ali fell LBW to Josh Hazlewood, who then bowled Mark Wood. And the England innings was wrapped up when Stuart Broad was caught at slip off Mitchell Johnson. All out for 312. That meant Australia had the chance to enforce the follow-on, but they decided against it. Stokes and Cook, the standout performers for England, who then faced a difficult two-hour session as Australia looked to extend their lead by batting again. England's only hope was to take their catches. They couldn't do it. Adam Lyth put down David Warner when he was on naught, and Warner duly capitalised, playing some nice shots on his way to another half-century. It had all rather fallen flat for England, and for one of their fans at least. Emphatically Australia's day once again. 108 without loss at the close. The lead now extended to a mammoth 362 runs. Australia's plan surely to push on in the morning session and then give themselves at least five sessions to bowl England out to square the series. And it looks like the weather may not even come to England's rescue.